Patrick, and we're four soldiers that are on duty here at Fort Mackinac this afternoon. Now, we're going to be firing off our rifles in just a moment. Before we get into that, I want to talk just a little bit about the uniforms that you see us wearing. You probably noticed that we have several different varieties of uniforms on display out here today. There's actually minor differences in the uniforms of all four of the soldiers that you see out here in front of you. Now, we are all dressed to represent men from the 23rd Regiment of the United States Infantry who were stationed here at Fort Mackinac between 1884 and 1890. If you came up to visit the fort any time during that, on any day during that time, you probably would see most of the soldiers wearing a uniform very similar to what Adam has on down there at the end. That's what's called our undress uniform. It's a very plain but very practical everyday wear for a soldier. That they would wear to do all of their regular work here around the fort. And probably is also fairly familiar to what famous American war does look like Adam ought to be fighting in. Yeah, Civil War. Despite the fact that by the 1880s, we're about 20 years past the Civil War, the uniform is more or less the same. It was kept around because everyone liked it. Soldiers liked it because it was comfortable. The Army liked it because of
And in the Civil War, most weapons were loaded by the muzzle. Now that takes a long time, often up to 20 seconds or even longer, but with a breech loading weapon, you simply have to open up your breech block, for which reasons these are named the trapdoor Springfield by collectors today, put in a brass cartridge, just like what you get in a modern hunting store, slide it in, close it, and you're ready to fire. Now a trained soldier can load, aim, and fire this weapon in about 5 seconds. Which is a huge improvement over the rate of fire they were getting in the Civil War. And these weapons are also quite accurate. Now here on Mackinac Island, at Fort Mackinac, they didn't have to worry about enemy attacks, so they could take a lot of target practice. And they actually practiced twice a week for most of the year. The only exceptions were if it was too cold or if the island was too crowded with visitors coming and looking in the national park. But otherwise, they went out twice a week shot at targets that were 200, 600, or even 1,000 yards away, and got very good at firing this rifle.
Harry, arms. Simple on the right. All right.